Hey guys, Claire here, and I am with my beautiful, lovely friend, Lacey Uhlemeyer, and she is also a commercial director.
That's right.
Which I love, because I started as a commercial director, and I honestly, as a director, you never hang out with other directors, because there's only one of you on set.
And a female director.
I had that. Yeah.
We crushed immediately.
When I first met Lacey and came over and saw the space, I was also struck by these incredible ceiling and the roof line and just like all the potential. We wanted to create a guest suite, like something that really felt like almost a hotel room.
Mm-hmm.
So you could also have like guests stay here, but then eventually if you ever wanted to rent it, you totally could.
Yeah.
You totally could. Lacey's main house is this beautiful 1927 cottage in Venice. There's all these adorable like original touches, and it's not a full-blown storybook house. I love those in LA, but it has a lot of those like little
touches. It's been
touches.
Touched too much.
Yeah. There's always someone in the 70s who like ruins LA houses. It's just sort of like a thing here.
More like the 80s.
Yeah,
and
90s. Oh,
yeah.
My God. Ugh. This dark 30-year period. So for in here, though, we wanted to bring in a lot of those same things that we loved about sort of the main house.
Mm-hmm.
And so a few things immediately came to mind. First was the wainscoting. We knew we wanted to do something like this just to create like a little bit of structure, but also break up the amount of wall. Because when you have this super tall ceiling line, it just could either feel like you're in just a plain white studio and kind of like, I don't know, almost like you're on a soundstage or something like that. And if you were to paint it a color, it would just be too much.
Too much, yeah.
Be way too much.
Claire kept going back to like this image of like a 1927, like Hemingway world traveler, like that vibe. And you know, every time you reference that, I was like, oh my God, I can't wait for the house to come together. It's going to be so amazing.
Well, that's the thing with Lacey, because she, before she started doing commercial work, she also did all these incredible documentaries. So you were traveling all over the world, like Peru, Guatemala, like Japan, like all these incredible places. And you had all these great sort of pieces all over your home from your travels.
Mm-hmm.
And so, I immediately went to sort of like, okay, what would like the cabinet of curiosities of like a 1927, like man who eventually got lost on the Amazon, you know what I mean? Kind of character.
Yes.
Like if like in my head, that's like Lacey, like a world traveler in the 20s.
I wish I was that cool, but yes.
I mean, you know, you look at your hat, you definitely are that cool.
When I first met Claire, and I think even before we met, I went to your lake house.
Oh,
or, sorry, Big Bear house.
That's true. The first time I ever saw your face was you FaceTiming because your husband broke it, like had to break in through like the kitchen window.
And it's
the whole thing. Yeah.
And I remember seeing the Big Bear house and being like, oh my God, she's not afraid to use color. It's whimsical, it's fun. And I feel like right now, like my Instagram feed can look so like beige and whitewashed. And it's just like, everything looks the same. It's like you could have come in and just made it white and airy and like really calm and serene. But instead I think we went like
the
bold
left
blue.
Turn.
Yeah.
The flooring is all like, what I love is it looks like old world European, but it's not. It's by Du Chateau. It's from their new Guild line and it's really cost effective, but then also it looks so beautiful.
Yeah.
It's engineered wood. So it is real wood, but it's that kind where you don't have to go put in, you don't have to like basically find a farmhouse and like rip out the wood to like recreate that kind of aesthetic. It's actually engineered wood that's thick enough that you can refinish,
that's
pretty cool. So talking about the paint color, we did a bunch of swatches, but this is the one we landed on, and this is by Dunn Edwards, and I love how it turned out.
It's
finding the perfect blue was so hard.
And it's like, I think the main color of everything, right? We like painted my old dresser
It's
just like so,
I know you had this old dresser, it was kind of like shabby chiced out, you wanted to use it, and I was like, the color is just not right, what do we, and we just like painted it. It's just like a solid color.
Really modernized it.
It did. And it made it part of the architecture, which I love. Dunn Edwards has this really cool app where you just take a photo of whatever and it'll pull out what colors of like what paint colors are in the photo. So I did that with the wallpaper. I just like hovered over the wallpaper, took a photo, and then that's how we found like the color palette for this. Everything here is from Hudson Valley Lighting. So they have a bunch of other like sister kind of companies underneath that. So there's a lot of Troy lighting. I think Corbett might be in here too. But for the lighting, we wanted all of that to also feel kind of like that 1927 cottage kind of vibe. So I love these Exeter lamps. They're so cool for the little like bedside lamp. Throughout here, we have the little Jasper lights. So these ones we kept more in that like oil rub bronze kind of look. Rendell loves music. He plays piano. He plays guitar. He plays, I feel like other instruments too.
He can play anything.
He's
so annoying.
Oh my gosh, he's very talented. And so what I love about the music room is we really really kind of kept that. Like, Rendell spent months hunting down the perfect piano.
Mm-hmm.
And
it was a lot of fun.
I just wanted that room to really be a celebration of that. So we did Lewis and Wood, Alhambra wallpaper all throughout the music room. And then these really beautiful brass fixtures in there just to kind of bring a little more warmth to it. Originally, there actually is the chair that was supposed
in
to go
office
there.
In our office now, yeah.
And this was on me. The chair was too big. I thought the chair would fit. It's this beautiful leather kind of cognac-y easy chair. I was like, oh man, what do we put in there instead? And you were like, what if it was like a little bistro set?
Yeah,
and I was
cute.
Like, that's brilliant. So now there's this incredible, it's a vintage table from Rejuvenation with their bentwood chairs. And it literally is a speakeasy. I love it. You can like, Lacey can have like a cocktail. Well, not now, but in a few months, you can have a cocktail and Rendell will be at the piano and it's like a total moment.
Yeah.
In the kitchen, the thing that's really special here is like, so we have the really beautiful semi-handmade fronts that got painted in like the matching color. So everything kind of comes together. And then the copper. This is like, I'm obsessed with that.
I don't even know where she came up with this idea.
Pinterest. Always like, Pinterest.
And it just wears so well. I think that's the other thing. It's
the
like
more
it can
messed
be a,
up it gets, the better. It actually looks better the more you beat it up.
It's a lived-in area.
For all of the plumbing fixtures, we're using Signature Hardware, and they had this gorgeous, very small, it's actually a bar sink.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, because it's like a teeny sink. But
it's a speakeasy.
It's beautiful. Speakeasy, it's this copper, like, apron front sink with a matching copper faucet. So beautiful with all the other copper tones in there. Low key, my favorite thing about this whole thing, that bathroom.
Yeah, it's cute.
The bathroom's cute. It's really cute. It has the world's, like, it's a petite, it is a petite bathtub. Lacey has the cutest little daughter, Adelia, and that's like her, now every time you guys go to the beach.
Yeah, we come home and I like take my shower and she's in the tub. But I remember initially, and this is what was so great about working with you too, it was like, we wanted this idea of the tub shower, but it was like, is that really what's going to work for us? Mm-hmm. And it was so great to work together and communicate and be like, you know what we can do? We can have this be like a wet room and put a shower next to the tub. And now
I'm obsessed with it now. Like when the decision was, okay, wet room, it just meant that the wall that was already in process was just getting pushed out a little further. And then it created this really amazing kind of like ensuite bathroom.
Yeah,
you know, it
it's
just
great.
Looked gorgeous.
Because it's so tiny, but it doesn't feel as small.
No, it doesn't. It really gives it a lot of airy, like light and space. And so for that, it's all these gorgeous like Signature Hardware pieces and the vanity too. And I mean, for us, like that whole room was a journey because we thought we were doing one vanity and then we realized that like the sink was exposed in a way that didn't look right. So now we have this really beautiful like white weathered wood. Mm-hmm. And then I just love how it turned out. And I love the fire clay tile detail on the floor.
That's like my favorite part, yeah.
I saw that in a, like, it was a photo of a 1930s, like, deco bathroom.
Of course it was, yeah.
I mean, yeah. Like, I love, I have so many, like, clippings like that from old, like, House and Garden magazines and that kind of thing.
Perfect. I mean, this is far better than the bathroom we have in our house. So we both prefer it.
So everyone just comes out here now.
Yes. Yeah.
Wait, so tell me about the surfboard, because we wanted to do a surfboard, and honestly, all the pretty ones were just way too expensive.
We almost bought one, but then my friend Priscilla Witte is an amazing artist, and Claire found this, you know,
on
just
Etsy.
Like blank wood surfboard. Yeah. We asked her to do a beautiful
Tanongo pattern.
And Priscilla had never done anything quite like this before, and I thought it was the biggest compliment that her husband was like, are you sure that we have to give this one, like, can we keep this project?
Lacey introduced me to Folk Project, and what Folk Project does is they work with, I mean, mostly indigenous women, right? From like Guatemala and like Chiapas, the very, very bottom tip of Mexico, sourcing different fabrics and then creating amazing projects for them.
We had this old bed that just had like a leather headboard, and it was like, how do I
make it special?
Make it special.
It's all made out of like wapils. So these gorgeous, you know, hand embroidered pieces. And what she does is they usually actually come as shirts.
Yes, we have like some extra ones.
Yeah. Totally. And so she just cuts them up and turns them into basically swatches of fabric. Mm-hmm. And then that's what this turned out. And it turned out so good. Well, thanks for letting me take over your back house.
Can we hug because of COVID?
I know. Can we just like, as long as we don't cough on each other.
There you go.
Well, thank you so much, Lacey. And
stop it. Thank you.
Thank you guys for watching. And yeah, we'll see you next time.
Bye.
When I do your big house, right?
Yes.